Shivers and Voids, opening track of the album, about insecurity and mental illness in a way that I think we are all very familiar with, and it's it sets the tone just right. Wow, yeah, Unforgivable, our second track on the album, is probably the fastest track that we've done in many years, and it just felt right. It's a song about being excluded and being displaced, and about, yeah, not being allowed where you are, and it's an angry, angry song. It felt just right. Next track is Neuronal Fire, about our inability to turn off sometimes. It's about not being able to silence the voices in your head, or silence or block out the images in your mind, and about able to kind of disconnect from everything when you're in a creative process, especially, but also in life in general. Not Nothing, and a late process song that took forever to write just because we didn't know how to finish it. But it's a song about our place in the universe and our insignificance, how futile things might seem and can seem sometimes, and maybe not how to deal with it, but how we deal with it, if that makes any sense. Drowned Out Voices, it's a song about how frustrating it could be to reach through the noise and the confusion and the chaos that is social media, news, and basically everything that goes around. Like, how do you cut through and reach out and get heard, because everybody wants a piece of that. It's not easy, and it's a frustrating feeling. I like to scream about the frustrating feelings I have. One of Us Is Gone Is Next, and it's a song that was written by Fredrik Johansson, our guitar player, who was with us in the band since 94 up till 99, and he passed away 3 years ago. And before, during his illness, he wrote a lot of material. He said, if you ever want to write something from using this material, go ahead. And we did. And so we wrote this song as a tribute to him and to the fact that we lost someone very dear to us, but also someone very critical and pivotal and instrumental in creating the sound that we still have. So it was a great gift from him to us, but this is a gift to him from us, kind of acknowledging how important he was for the band and for us. Last Imagination, the first taste of this album, and it's about like how I think there's a doomsday vibe to this album that it's just, I don't know, like instrumental to how we feel right now and how we have felt in the last couple of years, and this kind of takes the a little bit further by thinking that maybe this is the last kind of original thought you have, or the last time you feel inspired. That's what the song is about. So it's supposed to be. Our failure to accept what sees us to be and to give up on the idea. Another fast track, and this is Enforced Perspective. It deals with how we are moved in certain directions without us kind of agreeing to it or being aware of it sometimes. How we are pushed around into certain opinions and certain points of view that might not be your own, but it kind of eventually becomes yours. That's not fair, and it's not just, but it's the way things are, and I don't know. again, like, do a fast song like that and you want to have something to scream about, and that's definitely one of those things. Our Disconnect is up next. It's very rhythmical song and very kind of has a, like a groove based thing, and it's about our kind of need to detach, to kind of further distance ourselves from things, and how much that is needed sometimes in order to get a fresh perspective, to see things anew. And it did kind of envisions like a point where that's not even possible anymore. Again, like coming together with the idea of this post-apocalyptic vibe that we had for this album. This is one of our most kind of different songs that I think we have on the album. It's called Wayward Eyes, and it's very rhythm. It's kind of very rhythmic and in a cool way, different from what we've done before, certainly, and a lot of fun to write. It's about kind of having this explorer's view, having this kind of curious eye, like trying to figure out and trying to be curious about the world around us, but maybe not seeing things for what they are, or being in many cases very disappointed. Like the further you look, the harder you look at things. You might find things that you might not want to know, and that's a song that deals with that. This next track was actually one of the earlier songs that we wrote. It's called A Bleaker Sun, and it kind of envisions, and it's part of what is actually kind of conveyed, I think, in the cover artwork and the artwork for the album in general, how he kind of envisioned a world where not too distant future, and things are not looking great. I think an overall vibe for the album was not to be. Yeah, we were very worried about our future, basically. And so this came to our mind that it might not be better for each day, it's maybe the opposite. And for most of my life, I've been very positive and kind of tried to see the upside, but maybe not so much anymore. And so this is a song about, like, kind of realizing that night might not just be positive going forward. This is a song that Niklas, our original guitar player, you know, the band that I formed, the guy that I formed the band with all these years ago, wrote, because he's still very much a part of the visual identity of the band, and he's seen on every creative decision, maybe, basically, that we do still. And he's been writing a lot of material and over the years, and we said, like, no, I think it's time to kind of use some of that. So we took some of the material and we kind of reworked it, and we made a song out of it, and it became about identity, song about how we are perceived and how we perceive ourselves, how we view what others see in us, you know, and how easy it is to forget yourself, knowing that there's always like a picture of you or a video of you or a version of you that maybe you designed to be a certain way, but that's maybe not exactly who you are. So it was amazing to kind of write a song together with Niklas, even though we didn't do it like that. We did it in a roundabout way, but it became a perfect ending to the album, I think. It's a kind of, I like to leave an album like with some reflection or some afterthought, and I think the song works perfectly in that respect.